Thus, by years of cooperation and helpfulness, Ed Skelton has made the store like the hub of a wheel. Just about everything that concerns Southville passes through the store at one time or another, whether it's news or trade or trouble. Everything that affects Southville, Kentucky, affects Ed Skelton. But operating his crossroads store as a community center is not the limit of Ed Skelton's participation in the social and civic activities of his neighborhood. As a leading citizen, he's always been active in local and county government. He has worked with officials at the county seat in Shelbyville, seeing to it that Southville receives its full quota of public benefits. Ed has always worked hard for good schools and plenty of them because he loves children and realizes that real social improvement can come only from education and training of young citizens. He works to get the best teachers and to provide transportation to bring the children from outlying farms. School buses bring the children to and from their homes, and a favorite stop along the way each afternoon is Skelton's store. In an agricultural community, forward-looking citizens are always alert for improved farming methods. They try to increase productivity and maintain the quality of their land. Ed Skelton and his neighbors have sought the cooperation of agricultural experts. Qualified advisors from state universities and the federal government help them solve problems of soil erosion, drainage, irrigation, and pest control. Corn and tobacco are the two leading crops in this part of the country. Kentucky grows some of the best tobacco in America, and every farm has its patch of the fragrant leaf. Crop rotation, improved planting and cultivation, high-grade seeds, and controlled breeding of livestock all have left their stamp on the production records of this fertile area. But no neighborhood thrives on all work and no play. The people of Southville love informal get-togethers for hayrides and picnics. For a hayride, the flat rack of a hay wagon is covered with straw, and the guests pile on for a more or less comfortable ride to the picnic grounds. Skeltons and their friends spend many hours enjoying the beautiful countryside around their homes. In gatherings like this, friendship, laughter, small talk, and music are the rule. They ride gaily home along the lanes, singing the songs their people have sung for generations.
Hang your head over, hear the wind blow. Will you be mine, dear? Will you be mine? Answer my question, will you be mine?
Often in the evening, Ed Skelton's neighbors gather in the store to discuss community problems and exchange ideas. These people are well informed by radio and press. They're quick and alert to take interest in national and world affairs. Here a man may listen if he will, or freely speak his mind on any subject. His opinion will be respected, though it doesn't follow that his listeners must agree with him. Here, as everywhere in America, people like to hear all sides of a question and make their own decision. Almost invariably, the church and the country store are the focal points of life in a village like Southville. Sunday is the accepted day of worship, the Lord's Day, a day of rest. The cares of the workday life are laid aside, and the tolling bell summons the faithful to their church. Small communities like Southville are often built up by groups of the same religious teaching. They worship gladly and try to live together according to the tenets of their faith. When the service is over, Ed Skelton meets the Sunday train, which brings the big special editions of the newspapers from the city. Newspapers are printed and delivered every day, but the Sunday editions are very special. They're big and fat, with many advertisements, comics, sections on world events, home building, finance, and many others. Every city in the United States has several newspapers, and most small towns at least one or two. In this way, the people in Southville and other scattered areas benefit from great international systems that gather the news from all points in the world. Within a few hours of any given event, these country folk are reading the same news stories as the people of New York or Chicago or San Francisco. And they're just as interested and well-informed as their city brothers. Thus, our storekeeper becomes a dispenser of the news of the world. He brings editorials and sports and the world of art and the theater to the menfolks. He's a delineator of fashions and recipes for the ladies. He's the source of fascinating pages of comics for the children. When the simple and pleasing task of selling the Sunday papers is done, the storekeeper and his daughter return to their home. They may spend the day quietly here, or they may drive out to visit friends, or they might choose to go into the city to see a show or a baseball game. Whatever their choice, as they sit down to the meal, they give thanks to God for the blessings He's bestowed upon them, for they are humble and grateful people. Today, as always in a country store, the spirit of community life and friendship are as warm and unpretentious as storekeeper Skelton's round-bellied stove. Since America was first settled, the country store has played its part in advancing the development and culture of the nation. Such stores and such men still serve the people of America with hard work and simple dignity. Their spirit of cooperation and helpfulness is never better expressed than in their own words to a neighbor. What else can I do for you?